Hi Nick, thanks for joining us in the Aardman Cinema again today. I hear that you've been working on a slightly different project to your usual stop motion and that you've branched out into the world of music videos. I wondered if you could just start by explaining how the project came about and how you approached it.
Yeah, well, about a year ago, last December, I was lucky enough to be invited on Radio 4. There's a Radio 4 programme in the UK called Desert Island Discs, where they invite special guests on and they ask the guests to choose their top ever 8 records of all time, their favourites ever. And so I chose, classics, Neil Young, Bob Dylan, Van Morrison, Elvis Costello and a few others. But the last one I played was one by Joe Rose and Native in the Name called Plain Song. And because it just happened to find its way onto my playlist. And I actually know the family of Joe as well. I've known his mum and dad for many years, since art school days. So we've been good friends. And I've seen Joe and his two siblings, Jack and Esther, rise up as this incredible talent. And I've really just grown to love their music they've produced. And so it was on my playlist, and I wanted to play it just because I love it on that show, and it got such an amazing reaction. Nearly everybody has, a lot of people's tastes differ, obviously.
Yeah.
But nearly everybody said, "What was that last record you played?"
First thing I heard when passing through, dark was the arch, but through came sounds of.
I thought, wouldn't it be great to, if I could in any way, could bring a wider audience to Joe's music. And I thought, I'd love to make a video for that song. It would be a real challenge and something very different to what I'm normally doing. Aardman helped out a lot, which was great, and I had a fantastic crew that all volunteered as well. Some amazing talent. I'm so grateful for so many people who worked on the film who came forward as volunteers and gave up so many weekends and evenings. But there was no budget really, and it was being quite a serious song. It didn't seem quite right to use funny clay animation. I've done a little bit of directing live action, but not hardly any to speak of, really. So it was quite new. The whole thing was quite new to me. We used Aardman Studio to film the gig aspect of it, and we set up Studio One as a concert hall, and a whole coachload of kids came down from Joe's old school, the school that he went to. But yeah, directing and in front of an audience as well, I found quite nerve-wracking and quite stretched me a bit.
What was it like using different animation techniques and kind of things like that, rather than just stop motion?
Yeah, well, I found it interesting because everything basically had to be done on a shoestring, really. And it was, in a way, a challenge, but I find that often when you have very little money or resources, it forces you to make more creative decisions, in a way. I've always loved that technique of stop frame, pixelation, where you move people around in stop frame.
Yeah.
I love the effect it has. We had a lot of back projection material. We had this parachute material hanging up all around the stage, and we were projecting from 3 different projectors. So we'd spent weeks preparing all this footage already of the band, singing all the backing vocals. We'd filmed them against green screen, and then we supered in all this kind of stained glass window that I shot in Bristol Cathedral and Bath Abbey, kind of zooming in on stained glass window.
Right.
And we thought it would be really a nice technique to use this technique using a torch, where it's like when you wave a sparkler around and you can write in the air. And at one point we had the band kind of writing the words to the song. It was quite difficult because it's got to be back to front, so that the audience can read it. And that was too difficult to do on actually on location, so I did a lot of that at home in my living room, with the lights out, long exposure on the camera, got a torch and started to write each word. It took ages. It was great to, just the way when everybody believes in something, and obviously because of the love of Joe's song and Native and the Names music, how many people just come together, when we put word out that we're doing this video. We need volunteers, we need camera people, art director. I even had a friend who came in called Martin, who's studying as the feet of the band. Do you have the same boots?
Stunt feet.
I had to look for someone who's got the same boots as Joe. Stunt feet. That's right. The idea was to get this idea of calmness, was to show incredible busyness, really, with people whizzing, zooming around, because that's what happens if you take one shutter at a time, one frame at a time, but the main subject matter is standing quite still but moving in small increments. It has the effect of that person's fairly still or placid or moving slowly, but everything around is whizzing and shooting around, so that seemed to be on theme, really. What's amazing is that I haven't got tired of it yet, and the editor, Dan, said that as well. You can, of all the times we've played it back and back again, you still find it fresh somehow, and I think that's a sign of a good song. I really wouldn't have done this if I didn't love the music already, so that's the only reason I've done it, really, because I just believe that Joe and Native and the Name deserve a wider audience.
What's next now that you've finished your music video? Are you working on anything else at the moment?
I probably won't do any more music videos for quite a while. it's kind of writing now. I've had this feature film idea in mind for quite a while that I'm in early development on, working with Mark Burton, who's my writing partner. And that's coming together. I can't really tell you much about it. it's not Wallace and Gromit, I'm afraid, but it's new characters, for a full clay animation stop frame feature film, and it's an idea I've been playing with for the last 5 or 10 years, but it still makes me laugh. Wish I could tell you more.
Oh, it sounds like an absolutely fantastic project, and thanks for coming in to talk to us today.